Hey guys, today we're talking randomized versus observational studies, ECRG. Play the intro. Hey guys, ECRG here. Today we're talking the difference between observational studies and randomized studies. Now, these are quite different, as you can tell by the name, and there's an important distinction here because clinical trials, what most people know about are the randomized controlled clinical trials. But there is also some use for observational studies. So we're going to talk about the key differences here today in this video and some of the things you want to know when determining, when looking at the difference between the two. So what is an observational study? So an observational study is really a study where the independent variable, if you remember back to basic science, that the variable that the scientist controls is not under the control of the researcher because of either logistical constraints or there could be some ethical reasons, like some things you can't do, and it's out of the control of the investigator. So the next thing you would do would be an observational study. And one common observational study that happens is when you're studying the possible effect of treatment on subjects, where the assignment of subjects into a treated group versus a control group is outside the control of the investigator. And the reason why you would want to do this is particularly because, so just as an example of an observational study or why you couldn't run a randomized controlled trial is, let's say you were studying abortion on breast cancer rates. Now, for a randomized control study, you would separate the group, one group, into the ones that would receive abortions and one group that would not receive abortions, and see their chances of breast cancer. Well, an investigator can't make one group of women have abortions. You can't do that for ethical reasons. So he would just have to observe, like in an observational study, the incidence of breast cancer for those that receive abortions. You would have to look at the population of people that receive abortions and then look at their breast cancer rates. And then he would have to compare that with those that receive abortions versus their breast cancer rates. So he would have to observe that. He couldn't, make people get abortions. So that's just one reason why, why the investigator could not, manipulate the variable there. So there are many types of observational studies that you may remember from statistics class. You're going to have case control studies, cross-sectional studies, longitudinal studies, ecological studies. There are many different types of observational studies, and we're not going to go too in depth there about the different types. Just wanted to give an overview of observational studies. And observational studies aren't necessarily there to make definitive statements like randomized controlled trials would be. They're there to they can provide information on real world practice and uses of different things, and they can detect signals, and they're usually there to determine what you would want to study in the future through a randomized clinical trial, because that can show causality. Observational will just be an intro to what you would want to study later on. It can help formulate a hypothesis, etc., etc. So that's an observational study. Now we're going to talk about the randomized controlled clinical trial. So basically, the randomized controlled clinical trial is the gold standard when it comes to trials. And this is because it reduces for all types of confounding variables and biases along the way with the subjects being randomized and, double blinding and things of that nature. They reduce confounding variables and bias. So basically, the flow is you figure out what you want to test, normally an intervention of some sort, and then you randomize patients into one group that's going to receive the intervention, or one group that's going to either receive the current standard of care or a placebo, depending on what the disease you're studying is. And so this is basically the basic form. And then you will analyze the difference using some measurement at the end and see which one is better. So that's basically the basic interpretation of it. So why you would do a randomized controlled clinical trial, like I said before, is companies will use a randomized controlled clinical trial to submit to the FDA in order to get their drug approved. And in order for your drug to be improved, you have to show that it is as good or better than the current standard of care on the market. And companies will use this in order to get it approved by the FDA and to make it to the market in the hopes that doctors will prescribe it, or whoever will prescribe it, and their patients will use it and hopefully will increase their quality of life or something of that nature, or cure the disease. Now, we'll get into whether they will cure or just increase quality of life later, because that's not really the topic of this video. But basically, if you watch my last video on the different phases, that's what a randomized clinical trial is. And, there are some disadvantages to running a randomized controlled clinical trial. One can be how expensive it is. And if you watch my last video, we talked about all the different phases you have to bring it through: preclinical, phase one, phase two, phase three, and sometimes phase four. So these obviously cost a lot of money, millions of dollars. And also it takes time. And you don't know if you're going to get a return on investment if you're a sponsor, a pharmaceutical company. You don't know. Because they take so much time, and by the time you're halfway through, you've already spent so much money and time that a lot of them don't make it through all the way through the process. They will quit beforehand because they just depleted so many resources. And so a lot of drugs don't make it to market for that reason. So it's important to keep in mind that these things take time. They take a lot of years. They have multiple hands touching them, and it's a big effort to get a drug through a randomized controlled clinical trial, and one to be applauded if it makes it through the process. It's a very rigorous process, and you got to be flexible along the way with that. So that's basically the purpose of this video, to talk about the difference between the randomized controlled clinical trial and the observational study. So if you guys have any questions, comment them down below. We'll do our best to answer them. Thank you so much for liking this video. And don't forget to share this with your friends. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel for another video. And as always, guys, email us at eliteclinicalgroup@gmail.com. Take care.